After Reconstruction, the Jim Crow era of the South began. African Americans in West Baton Rouge Parish, as in many other areas around the nation, struggled to find a better life amongst these unfair laws of the time. Many believed that education was not just a right, but a key that could unlock a brighter future for themselves and their families.
My dad, I would have to say, he wanted us to be able to get the best education we could get and to rise to the level we could. And he even said to my mother, who wanted us to go to work when we became of age, that we could have had part-time jobs, he said, the white man doesn't put his daughters out in that field to cut sugar cane. He said, and none of my daughters gonna go out there either.
We didn't have anywhere else to go to school at a high school in the parish. So my mother had a friend in Baton Rouge on East Boulevard, and I lived with them. And I would catch the East Boulevard bus and go to McKinley High School in Baton Rouge. And that lasted about a year. The next year, that's when they built Cohn High.
Cohn High School was a very important element to the community. We had a high school in the West Baton Rouge area that the young people did not have to go catch the boat to go to McKinley High School to get that high school diploma.
Cohn High School represented the West Baton Rouge Parish African American community. If they had to have community meetings or if they wanted to have a dance, that building was used for everything.
Our teachers were very compassionate. They were very loving teachers. They took time with us. They made sure that we learned, and they also made sure that we got exposure to things.
Teachers were not just beacons to a brighter future. Some also served as leaders of social change.
I remember Mr. Searcy and his efforts to get National Food Store to hire black people to work in that store. The days that they marched and they protested, he was our biology teacher.
He was really instrumental in getting things done as far as being in the forefront with the picketing. He picketed. He walked that picket line.
Searcy and myself, we walked almost 100 days out there in front of the National Food Store to get them to hire bag boys and bag girls, not clerks. You follow what I'm saying? It prevailed. The guy came out of Houston, Texas, who's over the chain of stores, and asked us what we wanted. So then I told him, I said, we want some cashiers. He was dumbfounded.
The civil rights era brought about positive change. However, some of these changes altered the structure of support in the African-American community.
When they integrated the schools, they chose to close down the African-American or black schools.
We were told Cohn would no longer be a high school and would not be available to us, that we would have to attend Port Allen High School. But I felt the teachers at Cohn High prepared me to make the transition to Port Allen High, and they wanted us to know that they were preparing us for the challenges that were ahead of us.
We had great teachers. We could compete anywhere in the world. And most of us during my period, we went on to college.
And a lot of them did very good. You have a lot of very well-educated, prosperous African-Americans that came from West Baton Rouge Parish.
A lot of people we're very proud of, Mr. Felton Valdry. He was one of the young people who did the Crescentian. One of the brothers to Warren and Leon. They went to California. They became some of the best businessmen you've ever want to see. Edison Wheeler, he's in California, businessman now, doing just fantastic. And we just can go down the line that folk have left here and the ones who have stayed here and just done fantastic in their careers as graduates of Cohn High School.
We were limited on, I guess, a lot of things, but the community in the African-American area, there was unity, there was togetherness, and they believed if you had an education, nothing could stand in your way or stop you from being whatever you want to be, go where whatever you want to go, and do whatever you want to do.